I am here with the one and only Bolaji Alonge. It's great to have you in the house.
Thank you very much.
Wonderful, wonderful. Great to have you.
Thank you.
Of course, we're here to talk about your photography exhibition, which is coming up quite very soon.
Yes.
And we have some wonderful pieces here in the house, right? Okay, but then just before we look at the pieces, we were having a chat about our history and how photography can help us rediscover or get to learn about our history. Let's have your insight on that.
Yes, you know, from my travels around the world, I discovered, you see, people who know at least a bit of their history are proud people. And what I'm trying to do with photography now is bringing photography to young Africans. We can really understand our own history through photography. The beautiful thing about it is that you don't have to write. All you just have to do is replicate, bring up this image, show people, and then people make whatever they can.
All right, so let's start with the images that we have here. Let's start with the one close to you there. That looks like, I would say slum, but then I know you have differing views about that.
Well, slum is not the word I'd like to use for Makoko.
Okay.
This is
Makoko.
Yes, this is Makoko. That's the place where you see when you're driving on the third mainland bridge, facing the island to your right.
Okay.
Smoky, and you know, these. I call it the Venice of Lagos.
It is.
The interesting thing about this now is that we are bringing this picture on aluminium. So it gives it this, you know, vintage look. You know, I think
so
it's cool.
Printed on aluminium.
Yes.
This is wonderful.
That's the interesting thing about this photo.
Wonderful. Okay. Now there's this one close to me here. Now I can see. I wanted to say tadpole, but this is fully developed. This is a frog, but
and
very small.
Yes.
Where is this, and what is this picture about?
That's the green tree frog. I mean, it's. I saw this in the creeks of Ekpe, really deep, in parts of Lagos where you don't even know these things are. That's my hand. And and the green.
How did you get the shot?
Interesting. We were on the boat, right in the middle of water hyacinth. It's everywhere. Like, you see it for fields on ending. I mean, the people in this community, that is what they face in Ekpe. And this frog just came on, hopped on me, hopped around, and then, and I had my long lens camera. So, you know, I was at a very strange angle when I took this.
It had to be. This is wonderful. Let's look at the one just beside you there. Let's talk about that picture there. This doesn't look like it's somewhere in Nigeria because I...
Well, since I am having a photo exhibition, there are more photos to be seen. This is from my photo exhibition last year, the Eyes of a Lagos Boy photo exhibition.
All right. Okay.
Now, this is a photo titled The Lone Sit.
The Lone Sit.
Yeah. So, you know, it... that's what awaits you. Many Nigerians want to go abroad, want to go to Europe, want to, you know, but we always don't even think about that cold, especially from this part of the world. And it could be really lonely out there, and the seat could be cold.
Wow.
So that's,
that's what this picture all talks
about. The migration issue and all of that. So that's the thing
about it. Thank you very much. That's wonderful. Yeah. Now, there is this one just right here by my side. I actually can't decipher this. What is this? I know this is... a forest land or something, you know. But then, what is this picture
Well,
about?
I took this photo in Bronsum, the south of the Netherlands, about 2 years ago.
Okay.
It was autumn, around this time of the year, you know. Okay. The leaves get, you know, really brown, and I love to have people guess what this
what
is.
What this is.
I've heard white owl, I've heard egg, I've heard different things. So it's a game I'd like to put people through. But this is actually... a mushroom.
Mushroom, like the type that...
That kind of one where they talk.
So,
you know, it's about everyday life. You know, things people really don't pay attention to sometimes. And then you just bring it and show them. In essence, you are telling the history. And history is continuous.
Okay.
So this now tells you about the photo exhibition coming up at One Draw Gallery on the 11th of November to the 25th.
All right.
I mean, there are more of pictures about us. Urban culture.
Historical continuity.
Yes.
All right, and talking about urban, but this looks rural. Let's see, this painting, this looks like a masterpiece here. What is this about?
Well, this young man and his sister, I found somewhere inside Ekpe. Ekpe has really, you know, it left an impression because I thought I knew Lagos until I visited the creeks of Ekpe. I'm talking about about hundreds of villages scattered around the lagoon. You could only access some of these lagoon, these villages by boat.
Okay.
And these children are just waiting. This is titled Waiting Now. Waiting, I mean, waiting for what's next. This is really deep in the creeks of Ekwe, really
now,
far away.
Okay, now let's talk about this exhibition. You mentioned something about history.
Yes.
Now, you are collating the present for future generations.
Indeed.
But is there any way for us, now you mentioned something about Herbert Macaulay Road.
Yes.
Is there any way for us to go back in time? Now, this is for the future generations to learn about today.
Yes.
So that's safeguarding today for the future.
Yes.
How about the past?
Indeed, the past is that for us here today now, this is what we do. The interesting thing about history is that, you know, we can only look at what those ahead left for us.
For us, true. Indeed, because we cannot go back and bring
many things are left untold. But for some of us, we are putting it upon ourselves, especially the Eyes of a Lagos Boy project. It's about what we are doing right now, keeping it for those coming after us to see and to understand how we lived. So at the same time, we are enjoying it. We are enjoying this. But mainly it's for those coming after us.
After us.
So once you understand it, like I mentioned, Herbert Macaulay Road today, yes. The famous Herbert Macaulay Road, used to be called College Road.
College Road.
Before 1946.
Mm.
So people never knew this. Herbert Macaulay died in 1946. Yeah. I mean, Yaba College of Tech, that is now Yaba College of Tech, Yaba Higher School, founded in 1932.
Okay.
You know, started 1934. It used to be College Road. So that was where the colonialists had our people training them to now work in the colonial service.
Hmm.
So people should know some of these things. Don't understand some of this history. And once we know it, I mean, we'll be proud people.
Okay, so let's talk about the exhibition. What are your expectations? What are you achieving to expect? I know, yes, we're collating something for the future generation, but now this is the present and it's about a week long. Of activities.
It's 2 weeks.
2 weeks long of activities.
Yes.
What's the itinerary? What are we expecting? What are different activities?
Yes, I think for us, what we really should be expecting is to see how we live from Lagos to Bauchi to Anambra to Oshogbo to Isenyi to, you know, parts of Lagos and just how we Nigerians live today. It's just a continuation of our history as a people.
Thank you very much. I'm looking forward to it. And I'm wishing you all the best.
Thank you
very
much.
Have a successful exhibition.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.